Hi everybody, today I'm doing my everyday makeup tutorial to share with y'all. So I've already washed my face and I put on my essentials like my Mary Kay 3D eye cream. I like this one, it's pretty good. Before I was using this Dior Capture Youth, and this one actually works just as great, so I'm happy with that. And I use this 3D minimizing night cream because the SPF and the day cream, which I think they offer it without the SPF, but I don't have that one, sometimes bothers me when it gets mixed up in my eyes. I used to use a Dior Glow Youth serum. It was like a vitamin C, but now I use these little squares that I mix into my cream and they dissolve. But I noticed when I use those during the day, it makes sometimes like it get kind of grainy or something, so I try to just do that at night. And I love this CC BB cream, and I use it in light to medium during the winter and medium to whatever in the summer when I get dark. So I do two squirts of that, and I just kind of put it. Oh, I almost forgot. I put on before this some foundation primer that's pretty nice. It's like a smoothing BB cream. Maybelline makes one that's comparable. And an eye primer, and I put the eye primer on first and then the BB cream on next because it has the SPF, so I get my SPF on there. So now I'm putting on the BB tinted lotion, and I really like this for an all over coverage. Just really kind of really smooths out the complexion but keeps it looking natural. Like you can still see my freckles, but it like blends in kind of my age spots and stuff, so I'm really happy with that. So after that, I will do an all-over dusting with the translucent powder. And since I'm older, like I'm getting older, I've kind of switched my makeup gameplay from using a lot of powders to using a lot of cream. So this is like the only kind of powder I'll ever use. But, oh, I forgot to show. It's this Mary Kay. I'll close it so I can show it. Translucent loose powder. And I really like it. I keep in my purse, and I should bring it, the Chanel Sheer Powder. It's like a compact with a white lid and like black Chanel letters, and I like that one to keep in my purse because it's really like, has the color I need, but it's really light for like between the day touch-ups. But when I'm starting my makeup, this is what I start out with. So after that, I go for these chubby sticks, and I haven't found anything really comparable in the Mary Kay. I think they used to have something, but they discontinued it. This is like foolproof. I love it. So you can kind of like, my little girl laughs at me because she says I look like a clown at this period. But I just kind of like just draw it on like this. I'll do my nose, and I'll even do my eye like that. And then I just blend it in. I'll kind of start with the pink because I don't want the brown to muddle in with the pink, and I'll switch up like my fingers that are like haven't been tainted with the brown color to blend in that pink all the way. And I'll go into my hair like that, just blend and work my way around, and then like go. I saved this finger, it's still clean. I'm gonna do the pink on that finger, blend it on that side, and kind of work with the nose here, and I want to keep it like white there, so anywhere else it can go dark, like right here on the sides and like the nostrils, and here needs to stay white. And right here my brow crease, super natural, super effortless, love it. Okay, and then I got this with a coupon. It was like next to free. It's a Revlon. I thought it was actually powders, and I was super stoked when I opened it up and saw it was creams. And you can see which ones are my favorite. But I really love this. I just use it with my finger, and I put the white first one at the top of my brow like that. And I'll even use it for right here and right here, right here like that. And it just, well, that came out weird on my nose. And then do this side. And I know people say to do your eye makeup first, but I was just raised with doing foundation first, so I've kind of come with a solution that works for me. Because I've tried to do my makeup first and I struggle. It's a struggle for me, I'm not used to it. So I'm using the second one just in the crease right here. That looks real pretty. And I use my favorite one, the third one. It matches my brown bronzer kind of color, but it's more of a sienna color. Just kind of put that everywhere. And when I'm going out at night, I'll play with that dark one, but usually during the day, I'll just stick like that. And then I'll come back with this translucent powder and give it another dusting so it doesn't crease, and I'll give myself a matte powdering under the eye. So while I'm doing the eyebrows and smoky, oops, sorry, I kind of messed up. I did the matte powdering on the top, which I didn't mean to. I meant to do it at the bottom. Give myself a matte powdering like that. A little big powder right here. It looks goofy, but it keeps like the fallout from just like sticking to your face, and then you brush it off later. So the next thing I do is I look for my eyebrow brush, which I don't know where it is. There, I think I found it. This is an old ghetto Revlon thing that I just really like the brush. I think this was like the cream nourishing side or something. But I just use it to brush my eyebrows up like that. And I'll go ahead and do my lips. I usually like to put on like a chapstick first, but I don't have one. So I'm gonna use this really nourishing lipstick. It's actually a Mary Kay Sizzling Red. I don't know, it's like in this silver tube. It's kind of weird how it works. So I'll put this one on very lightly. I like to like do lip suicide colors where I use multiple colors. I'm gonna go with this pink at the bottom, which is a real matte color. And blend two. This is a Revlon. I love these. I think they discontinued because I picked a bunch of them. So I'm gonna go clearance. So then I'll move on to my eyebrows, and I've kind of worked my way up in the eyebrow game. First I used to just do powders, and then I found this Mary Kay volumizing brow tint that works well, but it's really like drama, and sometimes it'll go on too thick and just a little too much. So now I have this super skinny Mary Kay precision brow liner. This is cool. It's like just drawing on your eyebrows with the pencil, but it comes on really natural looking. And if you screw up, you just go back and comb it over with the brush and it looks great. So here I go. And I've learned it's best to start here at your point towards the bottom of it. So you see I started here and I built this up right here at the bottom. Because when you look down, you can see when you draw at the top. So the least drawing at the top, the better. Especially if you're like dating a taller guy and that's all he's seeing is that side of you, or that profile view, or that, whatever you call it, bird's eye view, I think is what it's called. So try not to draw, and I always kind of like check myself by looking down. But see, I just kind of color them a little bit. It makes a real big difference. When I want to go out at night, I want to look like more like Pow, I'll do the volumizing brow tint little mascara thing. But this works fine. So I'll show you when I go over with the other one. Just smooth it out. Really looks nice. That's it. I'm going to go over here and do this side. Like that. My eyes are feeling dry. I wish I would have brought my eye drops. They might be in my purse or in my car. So they say you're supposed to do like short, quick strokes like that. But
Even if you're like over here just literally drawing them on, they still look great. Again, I'll even it out with this brush thing. I'm gonna look down and see, oh yeah, I can go a little bit more right there. There you go.
Now I'm gonna do my... And I've been digging this smoky from Jordana Walgreen 199 eyeliner. They're like imitation L'Oreal's. I really like the way they...
Some of them really suck, but some of them are good, like their dark brown ones, the smoky one. So I just kind of carelessly don't worry about it being even because you're going to go over it with the smudging tool, and I just kind of really make sure I get in the eye part, like right here, down here. I'm really digging the brush from the top in there.
And then when I get to my to do my wing, I follow my bottom line. So I come in here and do a little bit like that, and then I go up from that to kind of match this point, but a little bit out. And then I just color in the rest. Simple.
And then you're gonna come in and perfect it with the powder on top. So don't worry if it's not perfect. And I learned from a long time putting on makeup, like my mom, before she passed away, she would always tell me that my makeup would be like too perfect. Cause I would seriously try to like match the exact same eyebrow, the exact same eyeliner, wing on each eye. And you gotta realize your face isn't perfect. Your eyes are a little bit different. Your eyebrows are a little bit different. And you gotta do what looks good on each one, which might be a little bit different. And those imperfections actually make you, like there's face symmetry, beauty aesthetics that are sought after, like the golden symmetry rules or whatever. But there's also the differences that make it really pretty and not so plastic looking. So that's it. I almost forgot, if you have any beauty marks like me, I like to take like the eyebrow perfecting tool and just do my color and kind of give it a... It makes it look more natural with your makeup. So I have no idea where my eyeliner tool has run off to. It has grown legs. It grew legs yesterday sometime. And oh, look here, it is a little bit, yay. It's from Dior, and I like it. I have one from Mary Kay that's actually like more perfect and smoother, but this one has kind of like a little coarse finish that gives it a nice, natural, unperfected look. I don't know, you can go perfect too, like it's kind of coming out perfect now that I'm saying that, but like there's some like off brushes, they're not all smoothly in line, so if you like run gently over the line, it'll give it a nice smoky haze look too if you want. So I put on a smoky, like a gray, I don't know, smoky color eyeliner, but I'm actually following it up with a Mary Kay brown color. But I think that they complement each other nicely. So I'll do a little dust sweep, do it the fallout. And that's pretty much it. I might go and take that brown and darken my peaks a bit for some like natural color variation, because the color of your hair isn't all the same color. So if you kind of like, you know, lightly dust it with a different color, it just makes it look more natural, I think. I'll go in here and dust on this side. Like that. And the bottom. Some people are like firm believers in not touching the bottom with eyeliner, but for me, I look like a weirdo if I don't. So, kind of dust out that extra powder.
Enough for the mascara, my favorite. My mascara go-to would be my Revlon. Change this thing because it fell out. That's what I really like. And my waterproof lash stiletto mascara. This is like the best mascara I've ever been able to find. I can't find anything else that I like better. If you know anything better than this, please let me know. So I'm gonna go torch my eyes real quick. Make my funny faces. I like to like sometimes pull down my lower lashes because sometimes they get stuck in there and then they'll curl the wrong way and they'll be like going up and it looks weird. I get like those spider leg eyelashes, which is no bueno. If I had to do essential makeup to get out the door, I would definitely throw on some BB color tinted cream, paint my eyebrows and my lips, and call that a day. I read somewhere that nice eyelashes and nice eyebrows are like some good psychological attraction to men of like youth or like childbearing hip type of a thing. So I was always trying to like make my eyebrows and my eyelashes pop. I don't know. I should be like chopping them all off now to run away from men, but I haven't given up quite yet, so keep these eyelashes popping with my funny face while I do it. So, I should be kind of explaining this as I do it. I'll do it to the other one. When I first try to curl them, I try to get as close to the base as possible. And I kind of like pull my eyelash lid up. If I need to, I'll pull the bottom ones down to get them out of there. And I hold on tight. And I squeeze, like my old jazzercise teacher used to say when we were doing our squats about our butt. Squeeze. I'm gonna like move it around a little bit. Hold on tight for a while. I think this one came out pretty good. Let go gently, because sometimes if you pull it off real fast, they're like stuck. Especially if you have like old makeup debris on your eyelash curler, which I recommend wiping off occasionally. It's like I just pulled off a couple eyelashes. Just fine. They grow back. Especially if you use this Mary Kay Lash Builder Serum. That's really good. I like it. I'll show you two in a second. But I try to start at the top. Just kind of like dipping the top part of the lash in mascara, because if you go straight to the base, I think it weighs it down. I start at the top, not all the way at the base, and kind of try to build up the lashes a little bit. And then after a few coats of that, I will go down to the base. And that, I think, gives them like a thickening power. I'm surprised my mom passed away. I had all like her old makeup and there was some unopened stuff and there was like this like a dollar store discontinued package of an Alme. It was a white tube with a purple stick and it was like one coat thickening. And I gave it to my little girl to play with. And when I'm playing with her, she puts on the mascara like on me too, and I end up looking more like the crow dude, but I'm surprised that one's pretty good, especially for not being waterproof. Oh, if I ever see it, I might pick it up to try it again. The red spot. There we go.
come back up here because these lashes are not cooperating. They're starting to look a little bit better. I got one light going that way. There we go. Does that work? Come back over here. And that's it. My hair looks still a little wacky, but that's my everyday makeup. Ta-da!